Hi, I'm a software developer. The advice that I give to junior and entry-level developers is to keep their showcase projects very well documented. Let me show you a good way of doing just that. My name is David, and for the last 10 years, I've been working in the IT field. I often receive CVs with lackluster project sections without any link to any deployed apps or GitHub repos lacking any description about the project or how to run or deploy the code. So what you have here is a CV that was sent to us by a fellow developer after we published our last CV review video. As you can see here, I have redacted their personal information, but for the sake of this video, I will be referring to them as Brian. And if you want to view our last CV review, you can access it by clicking here. Brian wants to apply as a junior Java developer. The first thing I see here is that it has 3 pages. That's way too long. This CV uses the Europass CV template, and it's commonly used in the EU. The Europass template is fine, but it forces you to enter some naturally required and naturally relevant data for a junior software developer. Before writing anything in your CV, you should always ask yourself, is this information necessary to apply to the position you're applying to? This is a good advice in general. For a software developer position, things like your picture, your address, your gender, your date of birth, your nationality isn't really necessary. So the CV that Brian sent me doesn't really look like a CV that was meant for a Java developer position. Brian has a lot of work experience that's not really related to IT field. Having a lot of work experience is always great, but you should probably avoid mentioning every work position that you've worked on. Pick few of them where you gain some relevant soft skills, like leading a team or talking to a client. I would suggest creating a standalone section that's called Skills, where you can list all your soft skills. Although there is a section called Digital Competence that is usual for Europass CV template, but it seems super lackluster. I would suggest listing your most used skills and where have you acquired them, like on a workshop or in a bootcamp or while coding your own projects. Having the education and training section is always a great idea, but you should always put some additional info or at least add some context to it. So Java development program in IT Academy is great. It sounds great, but I don't know what's an IT Academy. There isn't any link to the website of IT Academy. There isn't any context. I would suggest adding a sentence that explained what the Java development program in IT Academy is. However, the biggest issue with this CV is there is no project section. If you have no prior work experience, there is only 2 ways that a recruiter can test your knowledge. They can give you a coding assignment that you can complete at home, or they can look into your existing projects. Usually those are your personal projects, which you have created while trying to learn to code or improve your coding skills. If it's possible, you should always deploy all your projects, but also you should always write a great documentation about your project. Your documentation should be easily readable by recruiters, especially if your projects are backend related. And what better place to put your documentation in than a GitHub README file? Even though Brian doesn't have a project section, his CV provides a link to his GitHub profile. Let's see what happens when we click on it. Oh, so there isn't any pin repository on his profile. There is no documentation, nothing about the project. Let's try to click on source. No README file, just code. I mean, we can always click on a file and go to the code, but no recruiter will do this. For the sake of this video, I have created a simple backend project and put it on GitHub. It's written in Node.js, it's not written in Java, and every entry-level developer should have something like this as their own personal project. I will show you how I created documentation for this project and what diagrams I have put in the GitHub README. The project is called Serverless Email, and I try to create readable and precise documentation. Try to think about the README file as a place where you can put all the information about your project, plus some docs that are necessary to understand and run the project. You should always have an About the Project section that explains what is the project about. If it's a backend or DevOps project, you should always add a diagram of the whole architecture. You can help the recruiters better understand your skill set if you list all the technologies you have used to build your project. I would suggest adding links to the websites where you can learn more about these technologies. Getting started section is all about how to run this project. This will not be super interesting to the recruiter, but the devs that want to clone and run your project will appreciate this enormously. You can list all the prerequisites you need to have installed on your local machine to run this project, and you can explain the installation process step by step. And now, moving on to the meat and potatoes of this README. In usage section, you should explain your app from the technical and from the user perspective. If you are creating a REST API, you should mention what happens in the solution when each of the endpoints is called. If you are creating a web or mobile app, you can explain the flow of the app, from the onboarding process to the point when the user can start using core functionalities. The best way to explain your application to the end user is to create short stories about what the project offers. In a serverless email case, this is an educational backend app, and my users are developers, so I'm trying to explain to them what they can learn by exploring this project. I would suggest to put your email and preferred social media in the contact section of the README, so if any recruiter or developer wants to contact you, they will know how to do so. It's also important to have the project link somewhere in the README file, as this repo can always be cloned, distributed, and the information of the original GitHub repo can be easily lost. If you want to learn more about serverless stack and X-ray tracing in AVS, you can always check out the serverless email GitHub repo link in the description of this video. While writing CVs, every developer should put a giant emphasis on the projects they have worked on. Always include direct links to the deployed apps or to the documented GitHub project repos. Just remember, recruiters have limited time to go through each CV, and well-documented, easily accessible projects are the ones that get their attention. If you have any questions, you can leave a comment, contact me via Twitter, LinkedIn, or directly via the email in the description below. Hope this video was useful to you, and good luck with your future projects. This was David from CroCoder, and until next time, try to create less bugs than I do.